G'day again. With the LGAQ's 124th annual conference at the Gold Coast less than 3 weeks away, I thought it would be timely to share with you 10 things you may not know about your association. Firstly, the LGAQ is mentioned in the Queensland Constitution, an Act of Parliament, with the Minister for Local Government required to consult the association on any legislation they intend to introduce into Parliament before doing so, albeit there's no timeline specified. Number two, more than 14,100 jobs have been created through state and federally funded apprenticeship and traineeship programs the LGAQ has been administering on your behalf since 1998, with a combined subsidy of around $217 million. Number three, the Roads and Transport Alliance has been awarded the highest honour in the road sector in Australia by Roads Australia and in the world by PIARC, the World Road Association, for its now two-decade-old groundbreaking model of cooperation between councils on a regional basis and the state government to ensure the coordinated and efficient management of 150,000 kilometres of road networks across Queensland. The benefits to the community have been independently estimated to be in excess of $1 billion. Number four, the LGAQ has run legal matters on behalf of Queensland councils in both the High Court and the Federal Court four times, including the Gundawindi versus Tate matter, which is currently before the High Court. Senior counsel for the LGAQ will be shortly giving oral submissions on why we should be granted special leave to appeal the Queensland Court of Appeals decision in the Gundawindi versus Tate matter. Our track record is pretty good so far, with two wins and a draw. Five, since the inception over a quarter of a century ago, insurance schemes, local government mutual and local government workcare, have on a market-to-market basis saved councils and through them ratepayers a staggering $750 million. As of June 30 this year, the schemes have also returned $35 million in direct cash rebates to members, offsetting LGAQ members' subscriptions for many years. Number six, QCOS 2100, a joint initiative between the LGAQ and the state government. It's unique in Australia. No other state has undertaken such a comprehensive review of coastal hazard adaptation needs with councils. It has expertly mapped 6,973 kilometres of mainland coastline and 6,374 kilometres of island coastline to properly plan for our future. Seven, the LGAQ staff share between them more than 250 years of in-council experience. Extraordinary. Number eight, the LGA Data Lake and the LG Sherlock are also understood to be the only initiatives of their kind developed for the local government sector. We are unaware of any other state or country that has implemented a data lake and developed artificial intelligence tools covering all 77 councils to enable benchmarking so councils can be given unprecedented insights into their operations and to find savings for their ratepayers. Number nine, through the LGAQ's partnership with UK website company Jardu, the association is providing state-of-the-art websites to 61 Queensland councils. Number 10, finally, the LGAQ was awarded official Queensland Great status at the 2018 Queensland Day Awards. As you can see, there is plenty to be proud of, and it was really difficult to keep the list to just 10. We turn 125 next year, and the LGAQ is showing no signs of slowing down. We'll continue to push ourselves to be the best association imaginable for you, our members. The collective power of 77 councils is unbeatable. We thank all 77 councils for once again signing up for your continued membership of our association. Thanks very much.